Welcome to another video tutorial. I have received several messages and comments from different students to make a video about writing of a review paper. So before we start, let's answer some questions which are typically related to a review paper. So the first question is the research article and review paper are same? So my answer would be no. So actually, technically speaking, research article and review paper are not same. So if they are not same, so what could be the main difference between review paper and a research article? So before we go into the further details, I want to answer another question before going into the detail. So the next question, how many papers should I read to write a review paper? So this question is very important for some students, because some students are afraid might be they have to read a lot of papers so that they will be able to write a good review paper. So yes, technically it is right that you have to read all the papers, but smartly only you need to read 5 to 10. Actually, it is due to why I have said technically you have to read all. Yes, I mean, it means you should know what is happening all in the manuscript, but when you will read papers of one area, you will be able to get even idea only by reading abstract. You don't need to read the whole paper. So at least you should know that what is in this paper, and you can get an idea only from abstract. Although you should read all the contents given in any paper, but if you will be able to good reader, of course your understanding will be better to a specific word. Then even by you looking at the pictures, tables and the graphs, you will be able to know what has been reported in this paper. So at least 5 to 10 you have to read, and for others you have to read all the abstracts. So now I want to give a detail about the research article and the review paper differences. So let's start with the research article. So actually, research, as already explained, in research article you give your own experiment detail, like what you have already done in your experiments. So you give details of that experiment. So we already know that usually a research article has abstract, introduction, material and method, results and discussion. So the question, do the review paper have the same? So the answer is yes. For some part it is yes, but for some part it is no. But how it could be different? So actually we can see that in research article, you have provided the details of your own experiment, but in review article you will only report and write the data of already reported experiment. I mean, in this review article, when you are going to write a review article, you don't need to do experiment. You just need to read many papers, and you can get an idea and make a draft about the findings. So what you can report in review article, you can gather all the findings, you can get the knowledge gaps about any specific area, about any specific topic, and you can build your own understanding, and by getting all the knowledge, and you can give all the future perspective for studies, like what studies have already been done and what studies will be the future. So all these parts will be discussed in the review article. So which part should be the part of review article as compared to the research article? So if we talk about the first two, like the abstract and introduction, yes, in a review article we need to write abstract and introduction. And but there are two important parts which would be missing in the review article section, like there are no material and methods in the review article, and there is also no results and no discussion. Because you did not done your own experiment, so you don't need to give the material and method section and results and discussion. So but the last part would be the conclusion. Yes, a review article have conclusion section. So only these two parts are missing as compared to research article. So if we especially talk about how many there are, how many types of review, so we can talk about there are how many types of review which usually encouraged by the journal for the submission. So there are only main two types, although there are some other types, but I will only talk about mini review and review. Actually, this is the full length review, and this is called a mini review. Actually, this review and mini review deals with the same logics and with the same parts, but only the difference is that its length is only about 3000 words. I mean, you cannot write more than 3000 words. So in this, you have to be specific and very tricky in dealing and in explanation of your knowledge and gaps and whatever you want to write. So in this, the overall length should be not more than 300 words. So technically it is little more difficult than review, because here you have no limits. You can, your length could be around 6000 to 13000, whatever you want you can. Although other contents are same, but here is also another except. The mini review is only accepted by some journals. Not all the journals did not accept mini review. Only some journal like the Frontiers in Plant Science, this is a journal which accept mini review, and the overall maximum limit for this length is about 3000 words. So if we talk about review article, so it depends on you how long and how intelligently and smartly you can make your and design your review. And almost all the journals accept this review form, like many journals which are famous in plant sciences. I have listed Frontiers in Plant Science and IJMS, International Journal of Molecular Sciences. These two journals are usually paid, and you need to pay the publication fee that is quite high for some areas. So here are two, these are free. I mean, you don't need to pay any publication fees here, like the Acta Physiologia Plantarum and Biological System. These are two famous free publications for publication. They are journals, so you can submit them. They will not charge any publication fee, but usually their process for review is little longer than this. So going to the next, while dealing with the specifically how to write and write a review paper, the first step in writing a review paper, first you have to select the topic and you need to download all the relevant literature. Let's suppose whatever is your topic, you can design your own topic, or might be your supervisor or your institutions can help you, or if you don't have anyone who can help you, you can ask me in the comments. I will help you to design the topic. So here I have given one example, that is current advances in molecular basis and mechanisms. So in this review is already published, which I have done in my early career, like in 2017 I have already published this. In this I have detailed with the molecular basis and mechanism of leaf morphology in rice. So how I finish this review paper, I will be taking example of this. So let's suppose this is the topic. You can go for your own topic. So if you need any help, you can ask me in the comment. So what would be the next step? Make a plan on a white paper. So first you need to make a plan on the white paper, like what you want to do and how you want to do. You want to write a review paper on any topic like this. So we are clear which topic. So which topic next would be, identify the factors which affect the topic. Like in this topic, we need to identify what are the factors which can affect the leaf morphology. So this would be the second step. So it means first make all the headings. So then those topics, you need to convert all those topics and factors which are affecting, you need to convert them into headings, and you can leave the space empty after those headings, and you can read one paper and fill the data whatever the headings. Technically speaking, while giving example, I can gave on the next slide. So next, in the step three, you have to read all the papers, and you can find that which article you are reading can be fitted to which heading. You can, I mean, whatever you are reading, you can just decide that what I have read can be best fit into which heading. So let's take example for easy understanding. So let's suppose this was our topic, like which I have already told you, current advances in molecular bases and mechanism regulating the Lee-Marr function. So let's suppose this was our topic. So we can see that who molecular bases, it means there would be some genes which are regulating the leaf morphology. So in for our own understanding and for our my own easiness, I have divided into two main headings, like the role of genes in optimum leaf rolling. So the leaf morphology can be divided into two, like the one is leaf rolling and the other is leaf size. So because leaf rolling and leaf size both come under the leaf morphology. So broadly speaking, I have categorized into two main headings. So where did I get this information? Because I read first 5 to 10 papers and found that all the paper were related to either leaf rolling or leaf size. Then I have found that leaf rolling was only due to two things. First was leaf polarity, either adaxial or abaxial. So the second form that was affecting the leaf rolling, that was the bulliform cells. So actually these are two things which can affect the leaf rolling. And if we especially talking about the leaf size, when I was reading paper, I was collecting the information like number of veins, cell divisions, phytohormones, epigenetics, all these things and all these factors. I have get to knowledge that these all the factor may affect the leaf size. So I have just made all these headings. Now let's suppose I was reading paper number one and I found that, oh okay, this finding was related to leaf rolling, so you can put in this heading. Next, let's suppose you have find another paper in which they have mentioned the leaf size, so you can mention that article in here, like if that was related to cell division, you can write. Similarly, look, you can make a beautiful and logical story, and you can give details of all. Whatever speaking, yeah, if you want to be a good writer, then you have to be a good reader first. So if you are a good reader, of course, then you can be a good writer then. Here is another important point, that is model making. Yeah, I have seen many review paper by the students in which they just get the figures from any other, like the sources like the Google or from any other papers. You cannot use anybody picture without his permission. So it is best you can create your own figures in presentation PPT. So it means you can design your own figures and build your own understanding. Let's suppose, like for this model, although I was in early career, this figure was not good. I have developed this model to understand the leaf morphology. Here I can show you, like there are some genes, two types of gene, like one was the leaf rolling, which I have already said, and others were related to leaf size. So we can see that what are those things which are affecting the leaf rolling, like the leaf polarity, bulliform cells, parenchyma cells, cuticle, all these things can affect leaf rolling. And finally, they are affecting cell division, and they are going to control the number of veins to control the leaf morphology. And here is the list of those genes which are affecting the leaf morphology by cuticle. These are by controlling for the parenchyma cells, for bulliform cells, and leaf polarity, so all. So similarly, those genes which were affecting the leaf size, like the morphology, RNA chemistasis, and phytohormones, they were ultimately controlling these cell division. So all these things are going to control the leaf morphology. Similarly, for your own topic, you can create your own model by using your own creativity. It's depend on you how you present your understanding. So if you need any type of help in designing, making model or selecting any topic, you can ask me in the comments. And at the end, I can show you that review paper which I get this idea. It was already published in Frontiers in Plant Science. So this is the topic. We can see that, and here first there was, it's in, this was introduction, although introduction is not mentioned here. Then introduction, and after that two main heading, leaf role of genes in optimum leaf rolling, and the next heading, the main heading, role of genes in controlling leaf size. And here are the small heading like the leaf polarity, bulliform cells, clear enchyma cells, cuticle development, microRNAs, all these things I have reported. And I have also made a table of all the genes and symbols with their gene product, like which protein they are making and what is their function, and most important, what are their references. So it is important to mention that each line, almost each line except few, you have to mention that from where you get this line. Like, let's suppose like rice is a model crop, like this blah blah. So from where I get this, I get this line from this paper. And all, you can see that all the lines like this line have this reference. It means I get this line from this paper. So all these things you have to keep in mind. Wish you good luck for this. If you have any question, please say me in the comments. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.